The FFA admitted on Sunday morning that the only goal of the game in Saturday night's final, when James Donachie appeared to be in an offside position before heading the ball back for Kosta Barbarouses to finish, was not properly adjudicated by the VAR. That the system had broken down just at the most inopportune moment was something that no one saw coming, but it has left the FFA red-faced. System failure, James Donachie appeared to be offside but the goal stood. Photo, Fox Sports. In some ways it was peak FFA, that ability to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory. But it is no laughing matter for the participants, and the network failure for the capture devices to function as intended has inevitably shaped the course of the domestic game's history. That the system should crash in a grand final at just the moment when it was most needed was not just bad luck, it was the sort of calamitous fortune that sees a person fail to buy a lottery ticket on just the day that all the numbers he has been putting in for decades come up. Multiplied by 10, blame can't be attached to A-League boss Greg O'Rourke. He is merely the figurehead of the competition and the man charged with implementing a policy decision taken by the board and senior executives to introduce VAR this season as part of a global trial on behalf of FIFA. That's gone well, hasn't it? Incredulity, anger and frustration have been the watchwords pretty much everywhere the system is being applied. When decisions go in a coach's favor, he is in favor of it. When they go against, he abhors it. Ditto fans. What on earth makes FIFA and the game's governing body think that they can get decisions 100% right in the first place? The potential for implosion at the upcoming World Cup beggars belief. The VAR is just a tool, not a decision-making implement. Calls are still made by the referees in the bunker or box, the eyes in the sky. But they are humans, and their call is merely an interpretation of events. It may differ from that of the referee on the ground, they may have more angles of observation, but in the end it is still a decision based on their own judgment and interpretation. So, why complicate matters and bother with it at all if A, it only confuses things, B, it isn't always capable of producing a decision, and C, it may break down at the crucial moment? There is also a philosophical dimension to this. Is perfection possible, or even desirable? I am one of those who enjoys a bit of anarchy in my game. I don't mind officials making mistakes occasionally. It's part of the drama of the day and builds into the narrative over a season or even a lifetime. They probably make far fewer than players, although the impact is often greater. I agree with many who have expressed the view that using technology to the nth degree is against the soul and spirit of the game. Instead of minimizing debate about officials, all we are doing now is increasing the focus on referees on the pitch and in the stand. No wonder some, if not all of them, look scared stiff to make binding decisions. The Jets were unlucky on Saturday and lost a grand final they may have won. They got lucky a week earlier and put themselves into the position to make the title decider when, a goal down to Melbourne City, the latter's winger, Daniel Arzani, was tripped in the penalty area, but the VAR inexplicably ruled no spot kick, much to the amazement of the City staff. It could be argued that the VAR got it wrong on both occasions. So why bother? Yes, if we rely on humans, in real time there will be occasional howlers. But I would rather accept that in the game than go down the current route where the threat of malfunctioning technology is potentially the biggest howler of all. A League Melbourne victory. Newcastle Jets opinion. Michael Lynch, the ages expert on soccer, has had extensive experience of high-level journalism in the UK and Australia. Michael has covered the Socceroos through Asia, Europe and South America in their past three World Cup campaigns. He has also reported on Grand Prix and top-class motorsport from Asia and Europe. He has won several national media awards for both sports and industry journalism.